Let's all play What's My Line? Let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, forget those groans and wails. Let's say hello to Soupy Sales.
Don't stop now. Thank you, and thank you, Chet Gould. Well, this week's been a lot of fun because we have a great panel, and it's always a pleasure to have this young lady with us. She's a star reporter with Eyewitness News and a close friend of Howard Cosell. Would you please say hello to Melba Tolliver?
I didn't hear what you said about Howard.
I said you're a close friend of Howard Cosell.
Right. I must say, I've never spent a week with a more pleasant mustache, and it belongs to Mr. Gene Shalit.
And now a lady who needs no introduction and is not going to get an introduction, but I will just say, Miss Arlene Francis.
Here's everybody's boy next door, Larry Blyden. Oh, yeah.
Well, listen, everybody looks so elegant today for Friday. It's really gorgeous. And we have some marvelous guests who are also, let's see. Oh, you talk about elegant. You want to see an elegant guest?
Yes.
I'm going to show you elegant. You're not? You're, I'm not going to show you elegant. I'm going to take a minute or two and tell you how wonderful it is to see you again. And then we're going to talk about Arlene's red bow. Hey, Arlene, where'd you get that red bow?
From Buster Brown.
Okay, would our now, would our elegant guest enter and sign in, please? Jack Shaw.
Hi, Jack.
See, that that young lady has a little red on her, too, today. Where are you from, Jack?
California.
All right. This is Jack Shaw's pet, and her name is Jenny. Jenny does something which is very rare in Hendom, and we will show the audience what Jenny does. And we'll start the questioning with Soupy Sales.
Thank you, Larry. I would like to disqualify myself because I know that Jenny is a ventriloquist and Jack doesn't say anything. He's a big dummy over there. So. No, I didn't mean that. Nice, Jack. I'm just kidding.
But if you'd like to disqualify yourself...
No, I'm not disqualifying myself. What Jenny does...
Right.
Does she move around when she does this?
A little bit.
Is there, could any music take place while she does this?
A bit, yes.
Is that right? Would she be a dancing chicken?
No, she wouldn't.
One time, I'm sure she can if she wants to, but she isn't. Melba?
Is the unusual thing about Jenny and what she produces?
Yeah, well, not too
Well, not really. It's what she does rather than what she produces. Right. Two down, eight to go, Gene.
I assume nothing in chickendom really... has anything to do with this? I mean, I'm right in assuming, am I not, that she doesn't lay 7 dozen eggs a day, all poached or anything like that? No. Right. This chicken does something that chickens don't ordinarily do, and she does it to music.
That's right.
Probably dates a dachshund. Let's see now.
Well, there's music involved.
I know, but she doesn't dance to it or do a, or walk around to the music.
No, she doesn't.
Just soothes her a little bit. Is this entertaining, what she does?
Very much.
And I could speculate we may see some of it before the day is over. I hope. This chicken doesn't move a lot when she does it, though, or shimmy or anything.
Somewhat,
she just sort of stands. But that's not the main thing.
Not really. That isn't the main thing,
no. Is what she does that she knows how to stand still. I've never seen a chicken stand still for very long, have you?
Nope, that's not it. Three down, seven to go, Arlene.
Now, this chicken does something unusual.
Yes. Really?
And I can gather that she does not... crow like a cock.
Right.
But does she sing?
No, she doesn't.
Four down and six to go, Soupy.
Before we go any further, would you ask Jenny why a chicken crosses the road? Oh! Does this chicken Does this chicken...
To get on the other side.
Does this chicken ever wear something... Does Jenny ever wear something on her feet when she does this?
No, she doesn't.
Five down, five to go, Melba.
But the key here is the music, right?
Right.
Is Jenny on the... does she have both feet on the ground?
Yes, she does.
Very sensible chicken.
Yeah, maybe she flew to music or something.
She flew to music?
Does she make sounds?
No, she doesn't.
Music is on?
Well, you, she herself, you mean? Does she herself emit sounds
no.
when she does what she does?
That's not
what you meant? What did you mean?
She turned on the stereo.
That's what I meant. Larry.
Sure, that's what you meant. Six down and four to go.
But does she do something to something else that makes the music?
Yes, mm-hmm. she does.
Like she knows how to turn on a stereo set or change it. She can turn on the radio or put on a television set or...
Yeah, seven down and three to go, Arlene.
Nothing, huh?
Can Jenny play a musical instrument?
Yes, she can.
It. She can?
Very good, too.
Well, we have to find out what it is.
I'd like to see her strum a guitar.
Actually, she plays a tuba. And little drums.
Chicken on the keys.
That's right.
That's close enough. She plays the piano. We'll throw them all. Jack Shaw trained Jenny to play the piano in an act, perform at Knott's Berry Farm in Buena Park, California. How did you come to do that?
Well, actually, it was through through my family, my brother, my father, and I've managed the animal farm at Knott's Berry Farm.
How long does it take to train a chicken?
Oh, about 2 to 3 weeks.
And she really remembers it then?
Huh? Oh, yeah, forever.
Forever. Does she ever get temperamental and say, I wouldn't play?
No, because... Because they show him the fried chicken.
Colonel Sanders comes to the front door to get out.
It's a tough room to work, Jack. I'll tell you. Listen, why don't we find out if she's going to play for us today? Could we have...
Good at the pedal.
And here comes Jennifer with the magic piano. We're gonna...
Oh, look at that piano.
Oh, that's no fair.
Oh,
we
that's
expected
terrific.
To be
here. Here we see a piano, as you can see.
No, I don't.
And there, you see a chicky bird. Now, this chicken is going to play... Look at this.
She hit right from the top of the chart. I've heard of musicians laying eggs before, but this one can do it.
Well, oh, I dances. Like the footwork.
Are you dancing?
America.
She plays with everything.
Here we go.
No one.
Gotta get
That's My Line contestants receive these gifts. Sarah Coventry jewelry, fashion tie-up necklace, a silver-tone chain with tasseled ends and frolic bracelet with multicolored stones from Sarah Coventry, and Blue Luster carpet shampoo. It restores that soft, springy feeling to carpeting, and to make carpet shampooing as easy as vacuuming, Blue Luster's new shampooer 142. And St. Mary's luxurious no-iron sheets and pillowcases, patterns and solid colors for mixing and matching. St. Mary's instant high fashion for your bedroom. And now, back to Larry.
Thank you, Chet. And now would our next challenger enter and sign in, please. Ed Parker. Where are you from, sir?
Beverly Farms, Massachusetts.
All right, panel. Ed Parker is associated with a product that was invented in this country in 1934. Since then, some 70 million of them have been produced all over the world, and we'll show the audience what Mr. Parker's product is. And we'll start the questioning with Gene Shalit.
Well, I know about Mr. Parker, I'm afraid. So I'm going to have to...
Disqualify yourself?
Pass, which is part of the phrase, anyhow.
All right, fine. Thank you, Gene. Okay, Arlene?
Mr. Parker, I can assume that, of course, it is not the Parker pen. That would be too simple for us. Correct?
Correct.
Is it something that is in use a great deal?
Yes.
Is it used by men and women?
Yes.
Is it something that is can be held in the hand?
Partially.
Is it, does it do something to something else?
No.
One down and nine to go, Soupy.
It can partially be held in the hand. Is it something that...
Well, the whole thing can be held in the hand, Soupy, but when the product is being used, part of it is held in the hand, or can be.
Does it have anything to do with transportation?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Melba.
But it is used by both men and women.
Yes.
Partially held in the hand. Does this product have any moving parts?
Not per se.
Three down and seven to go, Gene.
No, I've passed.
Oh, that's right. I'm sorry. Arlene?
Is it a useful product rather than a game product?
No.
Four down and six to go, Soupy.
Oh, it is a game.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Aha. Is when this game is played, could it take a long time to play this game?
Yes.
Do they have green pieces of paper with figures on them that would be of money value?
Yes.
If I did something bad, might I go to jail and not collect $200?
Yes.
Is it Monopoly?
Yes.
Edward Parker is president of Parker Brothers Incorporated, manufacturers and distributors of Monopoly. How do you account for the enormous success and the longevity of Monopoly?
Well, I think it was a completely different principle. The game itself, the board and the playing pieces, are not as much a part of the fun of the thing as the confrontation between the two people off the board.
Uh-huh. It's a fascinating game. I used to play it all the time, all the time. My wife was a great player and a cheat. She would sit on $500, and you thought she was broke, and suddenly there was $500. Now, all types of records have been broken with this game, haven't they?
Yes, there have been a great fad for playing Monopoly as long as possible, and groups have played for as long as 700-odd hours.
My Lord. It's produced in every country in the world now, practically, isn't it?
Well, as long as you don't go behind the Iron Curtain.
It's produced. We have a board here that's in French, which is really marvelous. And where is it? Here it is. See, right here where there's Boardwalk in Atlantic City, they have the Rue de la Paix and the Avenue Champs-Élysées. And Chance is Chance, and the Allez en prison. Let's go to jail. It's really terrific. And then over here, when you're in it, this is en prison. Here's a simple visite. It means you're just visiting. Compagnie de distribution d'électricité. That's
the electric company. You said it was
company.
In French.
It was. This is really marvelous, this French board. Now, there was a big fuss recently, I know, that was raised because Atlantic City was going to do something.
Well, they want to change the names of Mediterranean and Baltic Avenue, and they've been on the game of Monopoly ever since it started, so we objected.
Did you win?
Oh, we won. I think this is probably where Gene recognized who I might be.
That's right. Really?
Yeah, they had the big... All the streets, and I don't know if everybody knows that, but all the streets and name places on Monopoly, I believe, are all from Atlantic City, isn't that so?
That's correct. The inventor came from Atlantic City.
So this Ding Bong, he's going to change the names of the streets now, you know.
This is one of the great games ever, 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 and thank you for bringing it to us all.
Great pleasure.
A chance to stump our panel with your occupation, send your name, address, and phone number along with information about your job to What's My Line, 375 Park Avenue, New York, New York, 10022. Let us know if and when you plan to be in New York, and please enclose a recent picture of yourself, one you can spare, because we can't return them. We'll be back with more of What's My Line and the appearance of our mystery guest right after this message.
If you're planning to be in New York and would like to attend one of our broadcasts, just write for tickets to What's My Line, Post Office Box 850, Radio City Station, New York, New York, 10019. And be sure to write the word tickets on the envelope. Now back to Larry.
Okay, we have time for just one fast round of who's who, so why don't we open the curtains, Lloyd, and play it. Here we have four folks who have graciously consented to play with us: a lawyer, a hearing aid dispenser, a sales manager, and one person sells radio advertising. The job is to hand out the card so that each person is holding the one which states his or her occupation. You have 20 seconds. We'll start with Soupy. On your mark, get set, go. And that is not correct. And here comes Melba Tolliver. And that is not correct. And here comes Gene Shalit. And that is not correct. And here comes Arlene Francis. Congratulations. And now would you tell us who you are, please?
I'm John Walheim, practicing attorney from Philadelphia.
Hey?
Philadelphia lawyer. Terrific.
And who are you, miss?
I'm Diane Storch, New York City. I sell radio advertising.
Okay.
I'm Joe Mazur, hearing aid dispenser from Memphis, Tennessee.
Okay. I am Charles Knapp, sales manager from Verona, New Jersey.
Okay. You've won $75. We have a special gift for each of you, and thank you for playing Who's Who on What's My Line.
Yes, each member of the Who's Who team will receive a Samsonite Silhouette Softy, the casual carry-on suitor featuring three compartments for efficient packing. Samsonite, we make travel a little easier. Larry.
Okay, we're back, and it's time for the special feature of What's My Line, the appearance of our mystery guest. Are your blindfolds going into place, panel?
Yes, we're all ready.
Gene, I can see yours isn't on. You're lying. There you are. Now, would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? All right, panel, you have 2 minutes. We'll go one question at a time, and we'll start with Gene Shalit.
Hi, Mr. Guest. Are you going to pick up my glasses for me? Are you in the movies?
Sometimes.
Soupy?
What's the matter with me?
Oh, I'm sorry. It's that's Friday. Right. That's what's wrong.
You had your blindfold on. He didn't see it.
Arlene?
Do you sing?
Yes.
Soupy? Are you a guy?
No.
Melba?
Do you sing? Are you appearing at a place in New York right now?
No.
Present time?
Jean?
Are you well known for records?
Among other things, yeah. Arlene?
Are you a popular singer as opposed to an opera singer?
Yes.
Soupy?
Oh, are you on a television show?
I have been.
Melba?
Was this in your own program, like a series or a special?
No.
Jean?
Are you primarily known for singing rather than for being in the movies? Because the first question was about movies.
Yes.
Primarily a popular singer.
Yes.
Right. Arlene?
Are you from Milwaukee?
No.
Soupy?
Do you also do Broadway?
Have done.
Melba? Yes, she does.
Are you appearing in New York currently at all?
No.
Jean?
Well, then who's sitting over there with Larry Blyden?
Ah, that's the question. You might try to figure out what she looks like. That might help.
What do you look like? Are you as young as your voice sounds? I mean, are you under 20 years old?
No.
Arlene? She's no Peter Marshall, I'll tell you that.
Neither is he.
Figure out what she looks like would make the difference. Do you look like the Dickens? No. Are you tall, dark, and handsome?
I would say so.
I'm sorry, we're out of time.
Kate Ballard?
Huh? No? Who's tall, dark, and handsome?
You're out of game.
Okay, I'm sorry, we're out of time. You gotta take him off and say hello to Lainie Kazan.
Oh!
No, we say hello to him. I saw you on TV on a movie the other night with somebody who was being very rude to you in this movie.
Oh, yeah, I've watched that movie a couple. Yeah. It's so much fun to watch yourself.
Roy Calhoun.
Yeah, Dayton's Devils. Oh, I loved it. Yeah, terrible movie, but I loved watching it.
He was being very unruly to you. Was it fun to do?
That was my first film. I just kept looking to see where the camera was, and it was fun, yeah.
Do you like doing films better than doing stage work?
No, I have to be honest. I grew up in the theater, and there's, for me, nothing quite like with a live audience, you know. I enjoy filmmaking, but I think it's not as fulfilling for me.
You do a lot of clubs, though, too, don't you?
Yes, I have.
How do you pick material to do clubs? How do you do? I've always wondered how one does that.
Well, I try very hard to feel out the climate of the audience, mm-hmm. and to find out what I personally want to talk about and what I want to sing about and what I want to say, because it's my chance to communicate, mm-hmm. and it's really like my own play. Mm-hmm. So for that hour or 45 minutes, I can talk to the people and say whatever is in my heart and on my mind, so I try and pick material that states what I feel.
That's a good way to do it. I never heard anybody say that before. That's lovely. We'll be back in just a minute. Don't go away. Wait here. We'll be right back. We really will. Melba, Jean, thank you for being with us on the program this week.
Nice.
Please come back. Arlene, Soupy, we'll see you Monday.
I hope so.
And you, Lainie, my dear, if you will come away with me to Paris, we can get 20,000 francs each time we pass Depart.
You're on.
Goodbye, everybody. We'll see you Monday.
This is Chet Gould speaking for Watch My Line, a Mark Goodson, Bill Topman production. Miss Francis Gowns by Bob Muteller. This program was recorded.